Ante Omnes. Today we're looking at Ad Italia from Latin for Americans book one. All right. In Magnis Undis. So in the Great Waves, the ships of the Trojans were tossed. Now these are present tense verbs. These are passive. You have the NT. We can go ahead and translate it past tense. A lot of times they use a present tense in a story like this, but we can go ahead and just, I mean, literally it's are being tossed. But the Trojans, from the middle of the waves, are servatur, are being saved, or were saved. And they hurried to Actium, which is a town in Greece, where there's a great battle later, or great naval, not such a great naval battle, but a very famous naval battle between Mark Antony and Cleopatra versus Augustus and Agrippa. There they found Helenus of Troy. Now this is not Helen, but another guy, a guy named Helenus, who's a seer, okay, who was ruling the land. Qui is who? Helenus convocat, called together the Trojans, and said a few words, or gave a short speech. Long is the road to Italy, to which you are preparing to approach. Go to Sicily, literally approach to Sicily, and these are imperatives, so make sure you translate this right. Please make sure you're correcting things as I'm going through. And sail from Sicily to neighboring Italy. Okay? Durum est. Now, durum est here is a construction. It has an infinitive, so it's an impersonal construction, meaning the subject is it. So it is hard to always sail. But fata, the fates, will find a road. Okay? And then sententia here is your subject. The opinion, or the words, the sentences, the feelings, the advice of Helenus is gratefully accepted, or was gratefully accepted. And Aeneas, remember Aeneas is your subject, gratas agat. Now this is a idiom. That Aeneas gave thanks to Helenus. It takes a dative. Castra moventur. Their camp is moved, or you say was moved, and their ships. Remember, naves here is ships. It's nominative plural, it's third declension, and the ships were entrusted to the waves. Okay, and so they start sailing. Italy, Italy, I see Italy, shouts a sailor, and points out the land. So they finally do get to Italy, but they're in southern Italy. On the land, and this is kind of a weird part, equi clari videntur, horses are clearly seen. Now, these are good Romans, so often they will, like, if something happens, say, if they step, as you step out of the house, like, the lightning flashes, it starts raining, then they say, oh, maybe we shouldn't go out today. So this is, they're interpreting as an omen here. The sign of battle are horses, says Anchises. War, garitur, is waged by horses. Okay? Battle, commit non debemus. So we ought not to commit battle. They did not remain there, but they sailed to neighboring Sicily. Okay? And Etna, now Etna here is a volcano in Sicily. It's still exploding today. It's pretty impressive. Etna scared them, and they fled from Sicily. All right, so where are the Trojans going? The Trojans, of course, are going to Italy to establish the race. But then we have a problem here. Remember, Juno, the queen of the gods, is a problem. Okay? Juno, queen of the gods. So, here we go. So, Juno, queen of the gods. Okay, who does not like the Trojans? Okay, where is the verb? Oh, we have a relative clause here. So actually the verb here is when. She came to Aeolus. Who's Aeolus? You might remember this from the Odyssey. He's the king of the winds, who rules and contains the winds. And she spoke. Que, of course, means and. But the thing is, the and goes here. And she spoke. If harsh winds will be sent, this is passive in its future, in against the ships. Now remember, in can mean a couple things. It can mean into, on, onto, or it can also mean against here, especially if it has the accusative here. Now, and if it's accused, it can mean into or onto or against. And this makes the best sense. If harsh winds are sent, will be sent against the Trojans, the ships of the Trojans, I will have a great gratitude. I'll be very thankful. And I will give to you great rewards. So she's bribing the king of the winds. And what does Aeolus do? Aeolus hastens to send Wentos in Nawes. Now, Nawes here is accusative again. So Aeolus hastens to send winds against the ships. Altis undis. By the high waves, the Trojans are scared. Okay? Arma, weapons, and men are on the way. So one of their ships breaks up. Then Neptune. Uh-oh. Is this good or bad? I don't know. Then Neptune, the god of the waves, hears the winds and when it comes to the place where the ships are. Okay? The ira, the anger of Neptune, is great. So he gets all upset that the winds are causing trouble. And the winds flee far and wide. Few Trojans are lost. The rest come to a neighboring land, all right, and are saved. But in what land are they? Non-scient. They don't know. Where are they? But they do not hesitate to set up camp. And there we go. Valete omnes lingua latina est vita.